Amazing, is it not? The Ampelos, one of our newest subjects. So, how are we coming along? They are a product of Elpis, and so named for their birthplace. A happy accident, born of the hands of a former researcher who loved beautiful blossoms. Unique for how they change color, to reflect the emotional state of those nearby. Though be it here or elsewhere, they are seldom seen in any hue save purest white.
Reflect the emotional state, you say? By what means do they achieve this?
In creation, there exists an energy wholly apart from Aether, one driven by emotions. In like manner to how we manipulate Aether, this flower is subject to the influence of said energy. While it has no will of its own, it is sensitive to the prevailing emotion in the vicinity, and reacts by altering its color and vibrancy.
Akasha? It is one of the unseen energies defined by Harnish alchemical theory. Though a gross oversimplification, some describe it as an essence influenced by feelings.
Though I'm not familiar with the term, your description suggests it is the self-same energy. Dynamis, we call it. And those entities like the Elpis flower that have the ability to interact with this energy, converting emotions into tangible phenomena, are Antilekis. That you are, my dear. And no ordinary one at that. But the first, possessed of free will.
Wait. A form of energy other than ether? Dynamis? I've never heard of such a thing.
Hardly surprising. Dynamis cannot be seen, much less felt. And though its existence has long been theorized, we had no proof until the flower's serendipitous creation. What's more, Dynamis is far weaker than Aether. Under normal circumstances, its effects are drowned out by the latter. On account of which, beings comprised of and reliant upon the Aether, like you and I, are unable to make practical use of Dynamis. Tis a truly esoteric thing, known to but a select few scholars.
Intriguing. Then, given the limitations you described, why create Meteon?
Our star, Aetheris, is especially rich in ether, so much so that its name is derived from it. However, when we consider all energy in existence here and in the vast space beyond, Dynamis may account for as much as 68.3%. The more abundant form by far. Were we able to control it, we could open the door to limitless possibilities. 'Tis not unlike a gently flowing stream, unable to break through the dam of Aether barring its path. But if we could imbue the stream with the vigor of a raging river... Not that I have such grand ambitions. Nay. I merely wish to create a being that could traverse the great expanse. The relative scarcity of Aether beyond the bounds of this star was a concern. And so, I looked to another source of energy by necessity.
That being Dynamis. No wonder her Aether is so thin.
Precisely.
Yours is thin too. Like an Entelechy. Like me. So, are we the same, Entelechies?
Well, aren't we ungrateful? Mayhap I should revert you to the pathetic, faded thing you were.
A deficit of Aether alone does not an Entelechy make. It would, however, make it easier for you to interact with Dynamis. And limited though its influence may be, this quality could prove the difference between victory and defeat. You'd do well not to underestimate it. Oh dear, I'd forgotten about the poor fellow. You must excuse me a moment while I go and verify a few more things.
No, you are not foisting this nonsense on me!
I'm given to understand you have the power to help the Charybdis, and should be quite willing to do so. And so I appeal to your better nature, most benevolent Emetselk. Please teach her to fly.
Or else Hermes will transform! Right now!
Now, there's no need to go quite that far. Altruism is its own reward, as I'm sure he would agree.
Oh, would he now? And who contrived to put me in this position, pray tell?
Nothing so devious. I merely suggested a possible course of action.
Nursemaid to your creations. I'd thank you to remember this favor and let it be the last. I will aid it once it has taken to the air. It falls to you to shepherd it skyward.
Well, let's relax and enjoy the spectacle, shall we? You were wondering why Emetselk joined the Convocation. Truth be told, he wasn't the first choice for the office. I was, on the strength of my ability to see Aether. But I declined the offer. For though my vision is exceptional, I am pedestrian in all other aspects. Worse even. Quite abysmal when it comes to manipulating Aether, for example. Couldn't transform even if I had a mind to do so. What good is the ability to perceive a problem if one cannot act to address it? Emetselk has no such shortcomings. He excels in vision and manipulation both, the latter to an extraordinary degree. If there is a mage more powerful, I do not know of them. Thus did I recommend him for the office in my stead. And I wasn't the only one. Far from it. Countless others vouched for his skill and character. People the world over, to whom he had previously lent a helping hand. Oh, how surprised he was. Claimed he hadn't done anything remarkable for anyone. Modest to a fault. He deserved every bit of acclaim he received. Yet he may well have gone unappreciated were it not for a mutual friend. A singular soul who can't help but involve himself in the business of others. Where he walks, excitement is certain to follow. His antics irritate Emmett Selk to no end. But much of his grumbling stems from genuine concern. When our friend calls, he never fails to answer and lend his talents. And in the course of doing so, he himself came to be recognized and respected by those around him. They are truly remarkable individuals, and I'm proud to call them friends. To help them realize their dreams. This will be my greatest contribution to our world. And when they have fulfilled their respective purposes, so too shall I have fulfilled mine. And together we may return to the star. Look at me, spilling my innermost secrets. I can't seem to help it with you. I can only assume it is due to the color of your soul. I just don't understand how you can be so alike and yet so different.
Well done, my pet. Well done!
Ah, yes. I dare say the Charybdis will be fine here on. Why don't you go and signal to Emmett Selk? Let him know that his arduous task is at an end.
Thank you. Thank you.